Don't buy a vacuum pump if you want to enlarge your penis or enhance its girth. Despite various claims on the internet and YouTube, your desires are not gonna be fulfilled. Save your money and watch this free video instead. I am going to tell you how penis pumps work and why I don't recommend them for penile enlargement. However, there is a renewed interest within the medical community in vacuum and traction therapy. I prescribe vacuum pumps on a regular basis for special purposes. My name is Stefan Buntrock and I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. If you like my content, please subscribe and support my work by becoming a member of this channel. Vacuum pumps have been around for over 100 years. It's the oldest method for overcoming erectile dysfunction. A cylindrical tube is put over the penis and the air is sucked out of it. This is achieved by an electric pump. The simpler devices are made for pumping by hand. When the air is out of the tube, this is called a vacuum. The vacuum causes a pressure drop within the tube and therefore also in the penis inside the tube. This results in blood being drawn into the penis, so the penis starts to erect. Pumps come in different shapes and sizes. Some are even water-driven. They have been prescribed in urology forever. But since the advent of Viagra, their use went down. Outside of medicine, they are marketed for homemade penile enlargement. This is not new either. Advertising has been around for decades as well. What's new is aggressive marketing via the internet and social media. There is an abundance of new customers. The old guys have seen it all. And the young guys don't take advice and want to find out by themselves. So here's what the scientific evidence has to say about the effects on penile enlargement. There is no lasting change, neither concerning penile length nor penile girth. In a small prospective study, only 11% of the participants reached a gain in length of 1 cm and more. Mean penile length increased from 7.6 to 7.9 cm. I don't even bother to tell you what this is in inches, because 3 millimeters is like, I don't know, 0.00000001 inches. Just kidding. Satisfaction with the outcome was low, only 30%. However, the number of studies on this subject is still small, despite an enormous and ever-rising interest from men all around the world. In another video, I will tell you about the more encouraging results from penile traction therapy with extenders. It looks like there is a small, yet sustainable increase in penile size from the regular use of penile extenders. Why do pumps fail to do the job? In my opinion, traction needs time. Vacuum pumps can only be used for 20 minutes, while traction devices can be worn for hours at a time. So time is of the essence. For traction to work, the tissues will have to be put under tension long enough so that the body can start to adapt. 20 minutes will most likely be too short to get the job done. Now, don't start using your pump for several hours a day. This will most likely damage your penis. As I told you in the beginning, there is a renewed interest within the medical community in pumps and extenders. I prescribe them for penile rehabilitation after radical prostatectomy for prostate cancer. There is convincing evidence that it increases the chances of recovery of erections. In Peyronie's disease, I prefer extenders, but in some patients, I favor a vacuum pump. There is now evidence that pumps increase the outcome of urethral surgery for stricture disease and also after prosthesis placement. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.